We're back. Let's continue. Rawabod. I think I'm only going for 2 hours because I want an hour before I have to get started with Cups Out Loud. So. No return. I only hope you bring good news. We scaled the cliffs of Ninkrip's Hope and spied smoke coming from Castrum Bano's main cannon. I think Marshal Tarapin's right. They didn't fire again because they couldn't. The cannon seemed to have disabled somehow. Then we must attack Castrum Abania at once. It could still be a trick, but if it isn't, we may not get a better opportunity. Bluntly, General, if it is a trick, it would be utterly baffling stratagem. Had the Imperials wished to wipe us out, they could simply have kept firing. Be that it may, we need not risk everything to seize it. I say we dispatch a small contingent to infiltrate the castrum and secure control of the weapon. If the enemy is preoccupied with the repairs, we may be able to take them unawares. If, on the other hand, it is indeed a trick, our token force would prove an elusive target and we'll at least know the cannon is operational. Either way, it would seem well worth the risk, but how are we to infiltrate the castrum? In the anticipation of a day such as this, men and women under my command have labored long to cultivate a network of informants throughout Garibania, including Radiata. Radiata is home to many who hold menial positions at Castrum Abania and other nearby installations. With the aid of our allies there, I believe we can secure a route into the fortress. The resistance behind this. You may have recruited these informants, but they'll be just as happy working with the fellow Alamegans. And at the end of the day, it's our land, our responsibility. Let us do right by Conrad. I should be glad to accompany our general, as would Alize and Essigos, I'm sure. Well then, if we're all in agreement, I see no reason to refuse you. We will make ready to march on Castrum Abania. Go, and may Ralgar watch over and keep you. My apologies for speaking on your behalf. I would seem that my sister's forthright manner is rubbing off on me. I confess my decision to volunteer was not wholly motivated by concern for Elise, nor less Alamigo. Castrum Abania is the largest Imperial facility in the peaks, you see, so the likelihood that Kryle is being held captive there is quite high. Dealing with that cannon remains our main objective, of course. If there is ever a chance that Kryle might be rescued in the process, I would never forgive myself if I did not take it. None of these. Red Mage Arm. Okay. Search of you, to travel to Radiata, where we could meet with a contact recruited by Marshal Turpin's agents. I took the liberty of reviewing intelligence reports while Essigos and Lys were away, so the settlement is not wholly unfamiliar to me. As the Vice Marshal indicated, the vast majority of the populace is employed by menial labor, neither Specula Imperatus or Castrum Abania. Perhaps as a result of this, the resistance has long struggled to make inroads there. You have the right of it. They got a better deal than most Alamegans, feeding off their scraps the Imperials gave them. Damned if I know how Marshal Tarpin's agents got one of them to turn his coat. I understand your disdain, I do, but I also understand their desire to look after the families by any means necessary. Our contact is a Rogan woman. She will ask her questions. After we answer with courage, she will know us as friends. Courage, right. Put together a squadron, Nago. We'll need them soon. With me, my friends, be ready for anything. Oh. I need to see this before. Oh, because I hadn't come over here. That's why. I'd always gone around. Are we on the peaks? I've got 5 of 10 quests. I'm a little behind. Each of the peaks have been kind of left behind. Getting offline thing. I need a... Focusing on getting through the main story so I can unlock a vendor. To unlock a freaking vendor. Hell, I might be level 71 by the time I get to the vendor. Really? Oh, man. What did I tell you? Let us continue to speculate in paradise. This is purple, which means that there's going to be somebody. Well, hello there. Of course there's still soldiers looking about. Fortunately, they are no match for Lise. Come. Ready. Rad is not farther. Of course, in light of our recent encounter, it would be prudent to proceed with caution and remain vigilant of Imperial forces. Follow the road. Really? There's a boss fight in the middle of the thing? I'll just outrun these griffins. Like it's safe to enter. I don't see any Imperials. I don't see smoke coming from Castle Albani anymore. Do you think they fixed the cannon already? Alphanar said we were looking for a Rogadin woman, right? And that we should answer her question with courage. I suppose we just have to strike up a conversation with every one of them until we find our contact. Let me know if you find her. I'll do the same. I ain't seen you before. It makes it kind of men to walk into a place like this of mine. Heard you say. Well, that is in short supply these days. Better to keep your head down and go along to survive. Call me a coward too, if you like, because I'll not speak on it more, at least not here. Outside Rodica, behind those barricades over yonder, on the other hand. Hey, was that who I think it was? Well, that's a relief or a trap. Either way, I'll find Alphanar and Alize, and we'll meet you there. Not followed, were you? Good. Yeah, but I do have some friends. It's all of you, is it? Let's get on with it then. Name yourselves. We are the Science of the Seventh Dawn, friends of Marshal Tarpin. Name Stock. Stock Woad. The rest you know, or you wouldn't be here. It's about Specula Imperatus in the canon, isn't it? Just so. Can you tell us what happened? Aye, I overheard soldiers talking while working in the mess. The Cerulean pipeline fueling the canon was destroyed by an unidentified male insurgent, they said. One man single-handedly disabled the canon? That beggars belief. Nonetheless, that's what they said. It took a while, but they finally put the fires out. The engineers have been working day and night to repair it. Wish I could tell you more, but the incident had everyone jumping at shadows and afraid to say much more. To make matters worse, the Alamegan help had been sent home indefinitely. So the cannon could already be fully operational? We need to sneak inside Castrum Abania to ensure the cannon is no longer a threat to our troops. Can you help us? Aye, that much I can do. I pieced together a map of the interior over the years. I know for a fact that there are multiple points of entry. Impressive. If we split into several groups, that may improve our odds of reaching the fire control center. We may be few in number, but I have faith that we can see this through. None of these. We have that which we came for. All that remains is to make our preparations. Eskos, you and your ever dependable allies will enter the castrum with my sister and I, by the way of ventilation ducts leading to the hangars. From there, we will proceed into weapons research and unleash bloody mayhem. At the same time, Alize and I will create a diversion elsewhere. In the ensuing confusion, Lisa and her unit will attempt to reach the fire control center undetected. If all goes as planned, our three parties will subsequently converge on this location. Together, we will secure the cannon before finally notifying the Alliance that they are clear to attack. Sounds simple enough. I'll go and brief Nago on the details. The rest of you come with me. We'll need to deal with the Magitek patrols before you can infiltrate the castrum. Almost there, friends. Your point of entry is just around the bend up ahead. The last patrol should be here any moment. Once you've dealt with them, we'll clear to advance, assuming they keep in their usual schedule. Might be prudent to stand watch for a moment after, just in case. Lurking in plain Zelda is perfectly fine. I'm about to go into another instance. By Rauger, I knew you lot were good, but I never expected you to defeat them so swiftly. Eskos is the finest warrior I know, and I should like to think that you have learned something from our time in our company. Now, to be fair, I'm a monk, not a warrior. Warriors is an axe-wielding. I haven't really gone through the training. I started it a little, but I really haven't done it yet. I'm a monk. But warrior in the general sense, not really kind of like the actual job title, then yeah, I suppose you're right. Because I could beat the crap out of anybody. Despite my small size, people make me fun of being small with their fists in their face. Now, where is the entrance to the ducks? Right behind you. I've mapped the branches so you'll be able no trouble reaching the hangars at any numbers or the places. Understood. Thank you again for your invaluable assistance. As discussed, I suppose we shall divide into two groups and proceed via separate routes into the castrum. Remember that our objective is to cause as much chaos as possible to draw the Imperials away from Lys and her men. There is nothing else. I return to the Resistance forces to show them their entrance. May Rauger guide you to victory. This is our last chance to make your preparations, Essigos. When you are ready of yours, we shall begin. Hold on, I need to get everybody on my link shell and then queue for the dungeon. I don't need emanation. Ostrom, I'm yet. All right, 8 minutes. What can I do in 8 minutes while we're doing this? Let's see here. You know. What are you trying to do? We were working in Yangsha. Let's stick to that because should have gotten that a long time ago. Keep wanting to press L for quest log. Alright. Finish up these quests quickly. Closest. Oh. Turn this quest. Just get it out of my quest log. I should turn it on a different. Here's. Right. Southwest. Southwest is this way. Can I get the one that's over here? Oh, this is where we came in from the Ruby Seas. I think I did get that one. So Southwest, right? Comes to the west. Due west. Southwest. 200. I was up here before. I didn't get the Aether card before. What was I thinking? That's a young man. All right, wait a moment for my health regen. All right. That one, I think. Oh, there it is. Those are some bigger, really big weasels. My father's looking for me, you say, but I can't go back yet, just yet. I'm still searching for what it was taken from me. I'm minding my own business, gathering mugworts and nasty lupins stole them right on my hands. Would you ask the lupin if they would give it back my plants? You'll find them on the other side of the river. Yeah, I'll ask them to give them back with my fists. This goes. He's a kind man. But he's got some anger issues. Lupin Looter. Nope. Victim of warts. Did you get them to return my bug warts? Yep, here they are. Oh, thank you so much. I've been trying to collect plants. Not that important, but let's commence this duty. See, 69 duty. All right, come guys, let's kick some ass. Ooh. I think our warrior is attempting to look like Lys. Lys is a monk, not a warrior! Stay inside the glowing stars! Oh no! The healer! Oh! Hopefully we kill him fast enough that he can catch back up. Oh shit. Oh no. Oh, this is not good. Oh, and our tank died! Oh no! Help with the healing. Am I taking? Oh, let me get the third stance. Oh, Jesus. Oh. Oh, my God. Oh. Well, that was fun. Well, what the hell? Why is the healer getting so pinged up? I don't know what's going on here. Well, hopefully the healer has divination ready. Don't stand in the stupid. No. Oh. Here we have. I'm not gonna waste using Brotherhood again. Nope, pass on that. And at no pass. Well, apparently we were too late, or you need both of them in order to not get the hyper-tuned. The hyper-tuned. It's just hyper-tuned. Well, let's get some food. May as well get some bonus XP. I'm not 80 yet. Moving on. Into another trap chamber. Oh, that's right. We've got more of these things. Yeah, gonna deploy. Got 2 million to go. Number 24. I keep forgetting on this one. Fire and lightning, fire and lightning. Nope. Okay. I didn't even remember that fight. I kind of didn't know what was going on. What do we got? Don't need that. It's Eurians. I don't need it. I got Menfina's Eurians, so. Menfina's. Not Menfina's. Menfina's. Yeah, we're just going to like travel through here, kill those little things. The little gauntlet. I can I have to say that this, except for like that start, in general, we're doing pretty good. And cutscene. How much you want to bet they're going to start it? Oh, there we go. Yay, Abomination! Now I'm going to teleport in. Hopefully I'm not in the middle of danger. Oh, I have a death claw attached to me. I trust the machinist to deal with that death claw. There you go. Even dealt with that. Oh, I'm level 71 now. Thank you, Kane, for starting the thing off without me and giving me everything that was in. I got player combinations! That was fun! I actually had fun with that. Yeah, no problem. A bit of abominations. That answers my question. We've accomplished our objectives as well. Lisa's unit should be advancing upon the fire control center in the command tower. Let us join them.
There's the control center. Let's hit them hard and fast. Ready?
Ralphino, cast sucker. Just give us a preemptive shield. I mean, Bertola, this doesn't make any sense, because basically every single Garlean that you ever interact with, especially the people that are supposed to be on your level, think of you as savage and below them. They're just never going to do that. They're always going to be like that. It's ingrained into them. Sure, there's probably going to be the few of them that would be like, look, let's... Hey, you may not be Garlean, but hey, you're fighting for the cause. Great, yeah! But most of them are going to be those insufferable bastards thinking that they're above you in every such way, because you're smart, they're smart, and we've got technology. Well, you're not! Come on! Anyways, that's the point.
Thank you. Lise, I leave matters here in your hands.
Right.
No, we did it. Castlevania belongs to us now. Nago and her people took Alize and Radita to Radita to receive treatment. Alphano tells me she's made a full recovery. I know it should be, I should be happy we won and minimal casualties, but something feels empty. We should report to General Maldin. Kryl wasn't here, but who knows? Maybe one of Raban's men found something that would lead us to her, get her to ask anyway.
Eskos, Commander Hex, fine work you did today. After Specular Imperatus, we needed a resounding victory like this. Thanks to you, Raugo's stall yet burns bright.
I'm glad I really am, but you should know that Alize was injured in the fighting. Recap. Incredible, and I am pleased to hear that you will make a full recovery, for Dola's parting words, on the other hand, ring less favorable in my ears. But if Xenos is wishing to invite us into his so-called royal hunt, then this bull would fain accept. What troubles you, Lise? Oh, it's nothing really. Just that we're almost to the end and we still got to save Kryl and do so much more.
We'll find her soon enough. Pippin has his best men scouring the Castrum's archives as we speak.
Listen, Lise. It will take some time for us to fully occupy the castrum and prepare to advance into the locks. While we wait, there's something I would like to show you, both of you. After all, this may be the last chance we have to catch our breath before the final push. I don't see why not. Then come with me to Radita. From there, we'll follow another road south.
There's the sewers we entered from over there. There's the Castrum.
Not Castellum, but Castrum.
There's an Aether Current quest here and here, which I would do offline sometime.
Oh, even though I didn't actually walk around up there, they did still mark it off on the map.
But after all these years, it's still the same. Ah, I'm getting ahead of myself. You deserve a proper welcome.
My inventory is getting full. This goes to these. I brought you here for a reason. Maybe voiceover? I don't remember. So just in case, I'm turning up the volume.
I wanted to show you this house. My house.
You mean this is where you grew up?
Aye. Not much to look at, is it? Same could be said of the village. It was damn near impossible to live off the land, barren as it was, which is why so many of us traded our plowshares for swords. Swords and uniforms, mind. We became military men. Tensions were rising between Alamigo and the Empire, and there was always a need for more soldiers to watch the border. It was only a matter of time before the first skirmishes broke out. It's a frightening thing to face Magitek armor for the first time. But after a lot of trial and error, I found ways to bring them down. After a few victories, people even said I had a knack for it. And then one day they hit us. Hard. I was wounded and sent home to recover. Back here.
Will you remain silent for fear of the Mad King's vengeance? Of his eyes and ears in the shadows and his knives in the dark? You, who call this living, dishonor our nation. It is but a slow death. Liberty or death? Liberty or death? If this be your creed, then raise up your hands, raise up your voices! Together we will tear Theodoric from the throne! Together we will reclaim our freedom!
Where's Elbird?
Send you home to men, did they?
Aye, sir. Garlean's got the better of us. The Chirurgeons say I'm healing well, so it won't be long now.
Liberty or death, is it? Tell me, soldier. What do you think those words mean?
We must needs be willing to die for liberty.
Spoken like a true patriot. But liberty should not be the end in of itself. Liberty is a chance to build something better. A stronger, more prosperous home for our people. It's not quick or easy work. And it is never truly finished. But if you neglect it, then sooner or later, you look up to find you've traded one tyrant for another.
Well, sir, I've never asked for much. Never wanted to live like a king, just wish it were a little bit easier is all. For me and everyone else. And I'm willing to die for that, if that's what it takes.
Dying is easy, soldier. Living is harder. Rest, mend. Regain your strength. You'll need it in the days to come. And mayhap one day we will need it too.
Conrad chose you as his successor, Lys. And I will not gainsay his decision. I have but one question to ask. Liberty or death? Those were Curtis's words and his creed. Will you swear by your father's creed before your comrades and the gods?
Liberty or death? That's all you can hope for in war. Father understood that. And you want to know if I do too. I swear to you, here and now, I will fight until the end. Be it liberty or be it death. But the freedom we win must be for every Alamegan, even ones like Fordola, though they may hate us, and the Enanta, though they may fear us. We'll fight, and we'll talk, and we'll find a way to make it work for all of us. Compared to all that, retaking our home will seem like the easy part.
A good oath. And there is naught else to say. You are indeed your father's daughter.
Even a blind man could see that Lise wasn't herself. Not that I don't understand. To be thrust into a position of authority under such circumstances, to be made responsible for the lives of so many, it isn't easy. And when you see your friend get cut down before your eyes, it only gets harder. I wager she thought Alize was dead for a moment back there. It is one thing to risk your life for a cause, but to risk that for another is a burden no soldier is ever really truly ready to shudder. The fear, the guilt, it weighs on her. That's good. It will make her a better commander. But first, she needs to learn to carry it. To not let it break her. To remember that some causes are worth fighting for. Liberty or death. Father's words gave me strength once. Mayhap they'll do the same for her now. Right then. I think I said enough. The two of you can head back. I mean to stay a bit longer.
Great mixer.
I understand. He's been away for a long time and he probably wants to be alone for a while. Let's head back to Rarita. Rarita. A little section of the fringes here. Wait, am I the only one who feels like I'm being watched? I don't know if it's Imperials or Bandits, but I know there's more than one of them. Let's split up. I'll head northwest, and you head northwest, and I'll head northeast. Maybe I'm wrong, but I don't think so. Well, I'm glad you sent me up this way, because there's an aether current over here. Moon's in the peaks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. A few more. Vicious youth. Hey, what's going on?
Seven Hells, he's seen us.
Sod it. Dead's as good as alive to the Imperials.
Bye. on. Where am I going? Yeah, that's where I'm going. Hey, how'd it go? They attacked you too, didn't they? I had no choice.
Yeah, Megan. Not even conscripts, if I'd look at them. Apparently adults, in fact.
Some of their faces look familiar.
Wait, I remember. They're from Radiata. They must have seen us when we were looking for Stark. And probably thought the Imperials would reward them if they captured or killed. Oh gods, Alize and Alphino could be in danger too. We have to get back to Radiata and find Nago.
Cool, I thought we'd submit some. Eh, or something else. But I at least got that taken care of. What's this all about? You two look ready for a fight. We're ambushed by villagers outside of Radiata and thought we might try to attack you too. Are you all right? Aye, we're fine. The twins are at Stark's. Alize was asleep last I checked. I'm sorry, did you say you were ambushed by villagers, not soldiers? Did they not see that what we just did to Castrum Abania? Goddamn fools.
These Essigos, we overheard you talking. The ones that attacked you, they were young. Listen, 20 summers.
Aye, I thought so. Almost.
Those the young ones, the ones who have only ever known the occupation. They're the ones who got... You've got to look out for. See, the only decent work to be found in Radiata is with the Imperials. And everyone knows it. Children grow up knowing it. They have it pounded into their skulls that the best they can hope is to serve an Imperial officer. Bloody fools. After everything they've seen us accomplish, they ought to be begging to fight for the Resistance, not against us. They've been living in the shadow of the Castrum this whole lives. A few victories won't change that.
Aye, we get some who can't wait to spit in a soldier's eye, but they get beaten for their trouble or worse. Even so.
And the ones that don't fight back but refuse to beg, well, they just starve. Beat the dog that bites the master's hand and ignore the dog that refuses to do his bidding, see? In the end, the ones that learn to abide are the ones that survive. Now, you may say that's all about to change, and I believe you. Many here do. But a young man or woman who grew up only knowing what he knows has got every reason to doubt. Remember that. Do what you have to if it comes to it, but remember that. The sooner we liberate Alamigo and bring an end to the occupation, the better. Only then can we show these youths that things do not have to be this way. Only then will we know what it means to live free. We're going to build a new home for ourselves, together. A better home than they've ever known.
Ethergird. Getting to one of my favorite quests. He says a proposal. Oh, into my armor chest. Good. I have space in my armor chest still, apparently.
I've been thinking. If Alize needs more time to heal, maybe we can move her to Rago's Reach. She can receive much better care there, after all. Our infirmary is better and probably the best place for her, short of sending her to Gridania. Indeed, and given that Mistress Alize, that Mistress Wode has told us, I'd rather she not remain here. And it's settled. Nago, go and see about getting us a carriage and an escort. Alphino, you should get your sister ready for the journey. Escos, would you mind going on ahead and telling Mirella that we're on our way? I want a bed waiting for Alize when she arrives. Thanks. Longer's Reach. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Holy shit, I only have 7 quests and I lose connection to the server. Of course. It even didn't zone me into Roger's Reach. Jeez. It feels like they just don't want me to finish this. I do have to say that for these 3 parts, I got through a lot of quests. So I guess I'm pretty good at speeding through things. Anyways, here I am in Roger's Reach. I need to go. Actually, I can use the Ethernet to get to Western Roger's Reach to make this go a little bit faster. You require assistance. Yeah, Elise is coming and she wants to make sure there's a bed. Very well, we'll make ready to receive the patient at once. Give me a hand, would you? There, all crisp and freshly laundered. We're here. Is everything in order? Right, we'll bring her in. Honestly, Alphino, you needn't have gone to all this trouble. What can I say? It seemed a good way to discourage you from limping off to battle when my back was turned. Listen to Aurella, please. You need your rest. I know, I know. Any news of Kryl? She'll be cross if we make her wait too long, as will I. Chilling prospect indeed. I'll find her sister, and I'll fight twice as hard for the both of us. We're good together. And they're not at each other's throats. Miss that feeling. Eskus, I have a favor to ask you. Would you mind waiting outside for me? I won't be a moment. Sure. Look at her.
Nope.
Turn up the volume.
Well, what do you think? I know it's a bit old-fashioned, but in a traditional sort of way, Ida wore it whenever she could. Not that I'm pretending to be her or anything. Not again. It's just... if this is the last battle we fight to free El Amigo, then she ought to be a part of it.
It's not that you're trying to be her. It's an homage. What's the word I'm trying to say? An homage. Best I could think of. To Ida. Well, this is as it goes. I don't think he thinks that it's quite your style.
Oh, I know, right? All these stupid frills everywhere. Anyway, the real reason I asked you here was to sneak in a warm-up before the final battle. There's this place I know where monks used to spar as part of their training. Care to join me?
Monk to monk? Of course. If you haven't seen the trailer for Stormblood, I want you to pause this video if you're watching it on YouTube and quickly watch that, then come back. I can't stop it. So much. it's only a few seconds, but it's great. I love it. Whee! One of my favorite parts of the expansion is that scene. Oh, God, I love it. Maybe we got a little carried away, but we have to admit that was fun. Thank you, Asagos. You're the best kind of friend, the kind that's not afraid to knock some sense into you. Yeah, I like practicing with my fists whenever possible. Also, I'm running out of space with my thing in here. I should probably fill some stuff off. Got a like 2 full tabs of gear that's probably not going to be used for anything. Probably just sell it off. I really need to. Come on. I'm going to go find a vendor and just sell a bunch of stuff off. Actually, for reasons, I'm going to call my retainers. My little Donnie in there. Trust. I'm just gonna like
Anything? I'll figure this out later. Oh, that's a thing. Okay, cool. Here. Oh, okay. Anyways. There, more space. Inventory management. Ugh. All right. Alize settled in. It's time we rejoin the fight. So, actually, maybe you and Alphano should go on ahead without me. I need to talk strategy with the officers, and it might take a while. I'll speak with Alphano. We're just keeping Alize company. Ah, there you are. What was it that Lise wanted for you? Just a sparring match. Ah, a sparring match with the destroyer's very problem. I would have liked to have seen that. But she is right. You have lingered here long enough. It's time to depart when we are. Take care, you two. Don't do anything I wouldn't. And you better not rise from that bed until you are given express permission to do so. Or Yonje will be paying you a visit soon, and he is already worried enough as it is. We have a long row ahead of us. Lead the way, yes, Goose. And of course, you go off and don't just stand there waiting for me to lead the way. Anyways. Oh, I think I got mount speed in the peaks. There we are. I wonder if this is one of those things where they probably just assumed that you had already gotten flight and you would have flown over. I don't know. Actually, no, I think there's another... Oh, no, that's a... Yeah. Oh, you know, I should have actually checked to see if, by some chance, for some strange reason, the vendor I was looking for might have gotten unlocked. But I don't think so. I think I have to wait until the end of Stormblood in order to access it, so. On that later. Abby, what do you got for me? Hey, I'm back.
I've returned. How fares your sister Alphino? Her rapier wit remains undulled, for better or for worse. Have there been any developments in our absence? I am proud to say that Castrum Urbana is now fully under our control. At present, we are taking stock of the enemy's supplies and redistributing them among our men. Also, while sifting through the officer's documents, we learned that a unit of Skulls under Fordola's command passed through the Castrum en route to the capital with a single prisoner in their custody. Kryle, it has to be her. It is all likelihood, yes. We will be glad to hear that the tunnel leading to the locks have been secured by our soldiers and now safe to travel. In one final piece of good news, reinforcements from all four Alliance nations have arrived and joined the main host, which has established a new base of operations within the locks. Commander Hex should be arriving soon, yes? When she does, we will call a meeting to discuss the final stage of Ralga's beacon. Sorry to keep you all waiting. An Alamegan folk dress. Well, how very fitting, and well-fitting, I might add. I wanted to do something for Ida, and for myself. This is it, the last push. We're coming, Kryle.
Gates are open, we travel through here, and I bet there's a voiceover as Lise narrates for us.
I remember my father's words, how they rang in my ears as we left Castrum Urbania behind and looked out over the locks before us. Comrades brave and true. They had come from all across Eorzea to stand with us. To stand against oppression and tyranny. 20 years the Empire had ruled us, but no longer. Liberty or death. Liberty or death.
Ere we begin, I would say to you as a proud son of Alamigo that I am grateful to each and every one of you for your part in this endeavor.
Unzar!
Now, to the heart of the matter. The enemy appears content to remain within the city walls and await the inevitable siege. Open conflict has been sporadic thus far. Whether Xenos is biding his time until reinforcements arrive, or attempting to bait us into a trap, none can say. We know better than to trust his word.
Regardless, we can ill afford to present Garlemald with a chance to ready her legions. It would be in our best interest to press for a swift resolution.
A long siege wouldn't be good for the people in the city either. If food becomes scarce, you know who'll starve first.
Just so. Therefore, I propose we commit our forces to an all-out assault. What say you? It would seem we are of one mind. Then let us proceed to the how of it. The Immortal Flames will form the vanguard, supported by the archers and the conjurers of the Order of the Twin Adder, under the Elder Seedseer's command. Once the main host has cleared a path to the walls, we will bring forward the artillery of the Maelstrom and the Temple Knights. I would have your cannons pound the gates and punch a hole right through the middle of their defenses.
What about the resistance?
Your part will be to occupy the residential district and keep civilians out of harm's way. The people are more like to trust their own.
Of course. You can count on us.
Remember that there is a second entrance to the city proper there. If all goes to plan, we will have secured two points of entry. Once both objectives are complete, we press on into the city, surround the palace, and hunt down Xenos. As for the Scions, you will be held in reserve as an irregular unit until we have more intelligence on your captured comrade. Kryle's rescue will be your primary concern, but I dare say we'll find a use for you once her freedom has been secured.
Thank you, General. I pray we find her quickly.
Ralga's beacon nears its end. Soon, my friends, Alamigo will be ours once more!
Stage is set and the players are assembled. Eorzea has come at last to drive the invaders from her lands. What would the grandfather say if he were with us today? For all of our other accomplishments, Kryle remains in the hands of our enemy. I find myself wondering if I, could have done more. Though we know now that she was taken to the city, we found nothing which might tell us where she is being held. You know, we could just ask me. Thancred, what have you learned? I shall spare you the particulars of my infiltration and simply state that I have seen her with my own eyes. She is being held within the residential district south of the city proper. I tracked her to the ruins of an old temple of the Fist of Ralga, within which the Imperials have constructed a research facility. A research facility? What manner of research? Why, methods to imbue Garlians with the power to manipulate ether, in pursuit of which goal their scientists have. I'm sorry to report, performed many questionable experiments on living subjects. What? Calm down, Alphino. You've already been tasked with securing the Alamegan Quarter. That gives us a reason to do it faster. I entered and exited the facility by stowing aboard Imperial transports, but the method is not suitable for a larger force. And it goes without saying that a direct assault on the rather substantial main gates would be ill-advised. I think I might know someone who can help. One of my men, he had an idea about how to get in the city. Actually, it might be best if I let him explain it himself. Been a while. I'll not take offense if you don't remember. Might even be glad of it. Alagana, am I right? Aye, Whiska is the name. I've raised in the peaks, but my mum's grew up in the city. Anyhow, I reckon you can get inside the Alamegan Quarter by way of the locks
of Lochseld. What? How? It was a story my mum told me, but which made me think of it. She was always going on about what life was like when she was a girl, see? How they used to have to boil the water from the well before they would drink it, since it was full of salt. They were drawing salt water from the locks? What makes... Which means that there must be an underground water tunnel or something. Aye, that's it. But it won't be as simple as going for a swim. The well was closed, see? Apparently, Theodric decided one day he wanted to control the water supply and forbade water trading, though even if you came up through it, you'd find yourself in the wrong side of a locked gate. At the time, my grandfather, being an enterprising sort, befriended a god and lifted the key from his belt. He made a copy and carried on selling water until the Imperials invaded, and he ended up working at the saltery. In short, we need your grandfather's key, assuming he still has it. I'm certain he does, and I can take you to him, but it will be dangerous. Don't you worry about that. We're used to dangerous. Nago and Arnvald will assemble a squadron while the rest of us go and get the key. Time for duty. Let's not waste any more time then, shall we? My mum said Grandad kept the key with him at all times as a lucky charm. If he hasn't got it, then what? And we'll cross the bridge when we come to it. Ready, Essigus? We may have to deal with a few Imperial patrols or worse.
Sultry is not far. Follow me.
We're here, but this isn't right. Where is everyone? Where the Alliance advance to surely reach their ears, maybe if they had sought refuge elsewhere. Look through things. Lumber appears to have lain undisturbed for some time. Being undisturbed for some time. Doesn't really help us with anything, does it? There's some place I haven't, like, stopped or anything? Is there anything else over here that I missed?
I suppose there's a higher ground. I feel like it should be like here. Can't remember. Oh, she didn't say anything. I looked at everything. Didn't I? I can't go up there because that's blocked off. It's got to be here. I don't think it's here. I think it's somewhere up here. Any carbuncle is not. What am I missing? Oh shit. I can't mount here. I feel like it was supposed to be in here. A waste of time. Can't go in any of the buildings. And down in this portion, here's somewhere, right? Nope. What is this called? The key to victory. See if my web resources can clarify what I should be finding, which I'm not finding. I feel like I clicked on everything. And I can't find anything else to click. Okay. Does the diary, it pops up in the area. Oh, jeez. There's supposed to be a diary that pops up here. That's what I've been looking for. But I'm not seeing it anywhere. Wait a minute. Did I collect it? Wonders Tales? Oh, Jesus, queer device. Now then, where were we? There we are. In the wake of the ambush, you find a diary belonging to a laborer. The last entry mentions plans to take shelter in the Sally Monastery.
Hey, monastery, that's to the south. I'll lead the way. Of course, they don't count any of this. Come on, Slowpokes.
Something tall, dark, and imperial appears to be blocking the entrance. This is it. This is the monastery. This have to be around here somewhere. What? What? It's me, Whiskar, your grandson. Whiskar, by Ralgar, is that really you? Oh, it's good to see you alive and well, lad. But who are these other ones? The Resistance, Granddad. My comrade in arms. She told you all about me thumbing my nose at the Mad King, did she? Death Sods never caught me in either. It wasn't much, but it was on my way of rebelling against his rule. Glad to see you better higher aspirations. Here. Make your family proud. I will, I swear. Ralgar as my witness. It was weird that he was when he wasn't at the Sultry, but we found him in the end. Now that we've got the key, it's time to find that underwater tunnel. We'll need to dive into the locks and look for a tunnel leading beneath the residential districts. That should be no problem for Eskos and me, thanks to the Kojin's blessing. But for the rest of you, I will have you know that I can hold my breath for 10 minutes. I think it best that I support Minago and Arnvald's unit. Right, you can't swim. I am aware of that, thank you. It's neither here nor there. Given that I lack both the Kojin blessing and Tancred's prenatural lung capacity. Right. Of course, I didn't mean anything by it. Nothing at all. So, Eskos, Tancred, with me. Let's head to the water's edge. Alphino and Whiskar can rejoin the others and wait outside the gates for us to let them in. All right. This is going to have to be a stopping point. I'm going to grab this Aether Current that I knew was out here. I'm going to look at my teleport list and realize I didn't grab the Aetherite. Means I'm going to have to run all the way back. I also need an hour. Also, it is 4 o'clock, and I actually need to essentially get ready for Cups Out Loud in an hour by making myself some food. So I'm going to end this here. I'm just running back to grab the Aetherite. So nothing special. And then we will continue the next time I find time to play. Because if I'm playing, I'm going to be streaming just so I can unlock this vendor. So that I can finally spend my tombstones so that I may do the thing. So I'm going to end it here. So everybody, thanks for watching. Might see you later tonight or might not be until at least tomorrow. So have a good day. Bye.